ஆண்டாள் திருவடிகளே சரணம். திருப்பாவை 5th பாசுரம். மாயனை மன்னு வடமதுரை மைந்தனை தூய பெருநீர் யமுனை துறைவனை ஆயர் குலத்திரில் தோன்றும் வடிவிளக்கை தாயை குடல் விளக்கம் செய்த தாமோதரனை தூயோமாய் வந்து நாம் தூமலர் தூவித்தொழுது வாயினால் பாடி மனத்தினால் சிந்திக்க போய பிழையும் புகுதருவான் நின்றனவும் தீயினில் தூசாகும் செப்பேலோரெம்பாவாய். ஆண்டாள் இஸ் டெல்லிங் ஹர் ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ் ஹவு ஷீ இஸ் கோயிங் டு பர்ஃபார்ம் த பாவை நோம்பு. ஷீ டெல்ஸ் தெம் அபவுட் ஹூ இஸ் த கோல் ஆஃப் தேர் நோம்பு அண்ட் த பாத் பை விச் தே வுட் பர்சியூ தேர் நோம்பு. தென் ஷீ கோஸ் அஹெட் டு டெல் தெம் அபவுட் த டூஸ் அண்ட் டோன்ட்ஸ் ஆஃப் த நோம்பு ஆர் விரதா. அண்ட் தென் ஷீ ப்ரொசீட்ஸ் டு சே ஹவு திஸ் நோம்பு வுட் ஈல்ட் ஃப்ரூட்ஸ் டு த சொசைட்டி. When she is saying all this, all the girls are listening very attentively. One of the friends gets a sudden doubt. She asks Andal, "Andal, your thoughts are indeed very virtuous, and we are all very fortunate to be with you through this Pavai Nombu. But somehow, I have some hitch in my mind. I am not too sure if we would be able to actually complete this Nombu." Everybody is startled. They are thinking, why? Why is this girl thinking a little pessimistically? Then Andal reads her mind and says, "Don't worry, my friend. Why do you think that we are not eligible to perform this Nombu or Vrata? As I had told you, we all have the desire to be devoted. So we can all perform this Vrata and complete it also successfully." But again the girl is insisting, saying that, "That's right, that our intentions are good now. But think about what we have done in the past. We all have committed a lot of sins. I have heard elders saying phrases like, 'Ahamaspi aparadha chakravarti,' meaning we are all emperors and empresses of misdeeds. We have done so many sins in so many births behind. So wouldn't those sins come in the way of our virtuous path? Would they be not an obstacle to attain our goal? I am really not sure if our sins will not prevent us from doing what we are supposed to." So now Andal understands that this is a grave question. So she decides to answer this girl in the form of the 5th pasura. Andal says, "My dear friend, please do not worry. I'll tell you a great solution to your problem. It's an easy one too. All that we need to do to get rid of our sins is to sing the glory of the Lord, to talk about His greatness, to say His names. Cheppelo Rembavai," she says. "Let us all talk about Him, sing about Him, speak His glory." Cheppelo refers to talking, speaking, singing His glory. "And how do we speak about Him? By what names do we call Him?" That she explains in detail in the Pasuram. She says, "Let us sing the glory of Mayan." Mayanai. Mayan refers to the one who performs amazing feats. Ascharya Cheshtitas. Lord has performed amazing feats in all His avatars. And the crowning avataram of amazing feats is the Krishna avatara. The entire Mahabharata is a compilation of His Ascharya Cheshtitas or Maya feats, amazing feats. So let's sing the glory of that Lord Krishna who was the hero of Mahabharata, says Andal. Here, Mayan also refers to the dark-hued Lord or the Lord who is black in color. It is said that Lord Vishnu's original color is black. And the Lord loves to be in this color because it is a color that signifies compassion and mercy. So let us call out to that compassionate Lord Mayan. Mayanai, she says. Next, we can call Him by the name Vadamadurai Maindan, Vadamadurai Maindanai, she says. Why should we call him as Vadamadurai Maindan? What does it mean? Vadamadurai Maindan means the son of the city of Mathura. The city of Mathura, known as Vadamadurai in Tamil, is the prosperous place which actually had the fortune of being called the birthplace of Lord Krishna. And the Lord was so fond of Mathura that he chose to take his avatara as Krishna there. Why? Because this Mathura was once upon a time the place where his favorite devotee Dhruva had performed penance. It was called Madhuvana at that time. And later on, this city of Mathura was also the capital of Shatrughna when the Lord took the Ramavatara. So Mathura was his favorite place because it is associated with his favorite devotees. So the Lord decided to incarnate as the son of Mathura. So he loves to be called by the name as the son of Mathura. That is Vadamadurai Maindan. So let's call him Vadamadurai Maindanai. Next, the Lord loves the place called Gokulam. And the place in Gokulam that he particularly likes is the banks of the river Yamuna. So let us call him by the name associated with Yamuna. What is that name? Tuya Peruneer Yamunai Turaivanai. We shall call the Lord as Yamunai Turaivan. That is the one who played along the banks of the Yamuna. And how is this Yamuna? This Yamuna is the most pious river, she says. Tuya Peruneer. It is the greatest amongst pious rivers. Now, piousness to any thing comes because of divine association. We start calling something holy because it has association with the Lord. We all know the story of the Ganga, which emanated from the left foot of the Lord. It did not even emanate from his entire foot, but it emanated from the toe of his left foot, that too not the whole toe, but the edge of the toe of his left foot. And this association has given so much sanctity to the Ganga that even uttering the word Ganga is supposed to make one pure. Now, let us compare Ganga with Yamuna. Ganga had this little association with the Lord because of which she is hailed as a great river. Yamuna, on the other hand, was the river where Lord Krishna took bath day in and day out as a child. He was always found playing on the banks of the Yamuna. He was so fond of the river that every now and then he would find a chance to jump into the river and have a dip and come. So the Yamuna is actually that holy water which has the connection with the entire holy body known as the Tirumeni of the Lord. So thus, Yamuna has greater piousness even than the Ganga. So it is called as the greatest amongst pious rivers. Tuya Peruneer Yamunai Turaivanai. Let us call him by that name, Yamunai Turaivan. So the girls are all happy. They are repeating after Andal. They repeated mAyanai, Vadamadurai, Maindanai, Tuya Peruneer Yamunai Turaivanai. Fine, what next is coming up? The girls are thinking. We should call him as Ayar Kulathinil Thonrum Manivilakkai. The Lord is like a lamp who has been incarnated in our Ayar Kulam, she says. Ayar Kulam is the clan in which the Gopikas were born. And the Lord has come like a lamp to dispel away the darkness of ignorance which is spread in this world. So let us call him as Anivilak, that is a lamp which has come to decorate our lives, or we can even call him as Manivilak, that is a gem-like lamp which has added value to our lives with its precious glow. So let us call out to him as Anivilakkai or Manivilakkai. We also shall call him by the glory that he has added to his mothers in this incarnation. Lord Krishna actually helped both his mothers in a very special way in this avatar. Lord Krishna had two mothers. One who was responsible for his incarnation, that is Devaki Devi, and the other who brought him up, that is Yashoda Devi. Lord Krishna drove away the fear in the minds of both these mothers, it seems. So Andal is saying, let us sing of Lord Krishna as the one who drove away the fear in the minds of the two mothers. Thayai kudal vilakkam seidha damodaranai. How did Lord Krishna drive away the fear in the minds of the two mothers? Devaki Devi was in constant fear of Kamsa because she had sacrificed 6 of her children in front of her eyes as soon as they were born at the hands of Kamsa. And she was really scared of losing her 8th child too. And Kamsa was doing this inhuman act because he was under the threat that somebody is going to come to kill him, and his suspicion was that Lord Narayana was going to come to kill him. When Lord Krishna came as a son to Devaki Devi, his incarnation was such that he was holding the conch and the discus in his hands as a baby, as soon as he was incarnated. So looking at this child, Devaki Devi got scared for a moment because this child is revealing so vividly that it is Lord Narayana. So she was scared that Kamsa would immediately find out and try to harm her child. So she requested baby Krishna to hide his identity as Narayana, to hide his conch and discus, so that he could be saved from the wrath of Kamsa. And the Lord listened to his mother and immediately hid his conch and discus. And it is said that till Kamsa Samhara, or till Kamsa was slain, Lord Krishna was seen to be only with two hands. And otherwise during the avatara, after Kamsa was slain, Lord Krishna was to be seen with four hands as he was the incarnation of Lord Vishnu. So thus, he drove away the fear of Kamsa from his mother Devaki's mind. How did he drive away the fear of Yashoda's mind? Andal says, by becoming Damodara, Krishna drove away the fear in Yashoda's mind. What is the story of Lord Krishna having become Damodara? Damodara refers to the one having a rope around his stomach or waist. We all know the story of butter stealing Krishna. Krishna used to be very fond of butter, and not being satisfied with the butter given at home, he would go to each and every house of Gokulam to get his share of butter from those houses. During one such time, the Gopikas decided to complain against Lord Krishna to Yashoda, and they did so. Yashoda was a little displeased with her child for his pranks and decided to somehow punish him, act like she's punishing him, so that the child gets scared and doesn't repeat this mistake. So she caught hold of Krishna and tied him with a rope to a motor, that is oral, they call in Tamil. Now, because Lord Krishna was being tied to the rope, the entire of Gokulam had collected there to witness that scene. Yashoda could not so easily tie Krishna with that rope, it seems. She tried to pick up a rope and tie him. The rope was almost enough to tie the child, but somehow, somewhere, it was about 2 inches less than what was required. So this child Krishna was growing, she thought. So she thought that maybe the rope that she was using was insufficient. So she went ahead and found another bit of a rope lying around. She attached this bit to the existing rope and tried to tie it back again. To her surprise, she found that the same gap of 2 inches was still prevailing. Again, she found another bit of rope lying around.
which she tied to the longer rope and again tried to tie Krishna. But again, the same 2 inches gap was remaining. Thus, she kept on joining bits of ropes and kept on trying to tie Krishna. Kanni nun siruttaminal, describes Alvar when he talks about this event. But all the time, she was not successful in tying the Lord. And everybody around started looking at Yashoda. And they started making comments that Yashoda is not even capable of tying this little child. Oh my God, what will this lady do? And such kind of gossipy talks started moving around the crowd. And this led Yashoda to a lot of embarrassment. Then she requested Lord Krishna that, oh my child Krishna, won't you let me tie you? And this appeal of the mother was heard by the Lord. And as soon as she said this, the Lord let her tie him. And she was able to make the final knot and make him Damodara. That is, the Lord who had the rope tied around his stomach. Thus, becoming Damodara, he drove away that insecurity in the mind of his mother, which was developing by the comments that people around were giving her. So he drove away the fear in her heart. Thus, he became Thayai Kudal Vilakkam Seyyum Damodaran. Thayai Kudal Vilakkam Seyyum refers to the one who drove away the fear from the heart of his mother. So he drove away the fear from the hearts of both his mothers, Devaki and Yashoda. So let's sing his glory, says Andal. Now, if we sing the glory of this Lord and also offer flower service to him, he will be so pleased, she's saying. Tuyomai vandu naam tu malar tuvi tholudu. Let us all go with a pure heart and perform flower service to him. Here, the Purvacharyas have given a beautiful explanation of what exactly is meant by flower service or what kinds of flowers can we offer to the Lord when we are trying to serve him. It is said that 8 kinds of flowers can be offered to the Lord as service. It is said that ahimsa, non-violence, is a kind of flower that we can offer to the Lord. Ahimsa prathamam pushpam. The next kind of flower that we can offer is control of senses, called as indriya nigraha. The next kind of flower that we can offer to the Lord is treating fellow beings with compassion, sarvabhuta daya pushpam. The next is forgiving anybody who has wronged us, kshama pushpam viseshataha. That is the most important, they say. We should be able to forgive. The next is jnana pushpam. By getting knowledge about the Lord, we can do service to him. So that is also like a flower. Knowledge is like a flower. Jnana pushpam. The next is tapa pushpam. Doing penance about the Lord is also doing service to him, like offering a flower to him. The next is maintaining calmness is also service to the Lord, shanti pushpam. And then finally, the most important thing is to speak the truth. That is the best kind of service we can offer to the Lord. Satyam ashtavidham pushpam, they say. There are 8 kinds of flowers which we can offer as service to the Lord. That is ahimsa, indriya nigraha, sarvabhuta daya, kshama, jnana, tapas, shakti and satyam. So let us offer all these to the Lord, Andal says. We have to offer all these by the mind. And we all have the desire to be devoted. So it's very easy for us to offer these flowers to the Lord. So let us proceed, she says. Thus, if we sing with our mouths and be devoted in the mind, vayinal paadi manathinal sindika. If we sing through our mouths, that is vayinal paadi, and sincerely think with the mind about this service, manathinal sindhika, what will happen? All our sins will go and get destroyed as if cotton is thrown into the fire. Teenil tu sagum cheppelo rembavai. And she's saying, what all will go into the fire? All our sins. Which kind of sins? போய பிழையும் புகுதருவான் நின்றனவும். All the sins that have been accumulated over various births, called as Sanchita Papa, that is Poya Pirai, and the sins which have started giving us fruits, called Prarabdha Karma. Basically, the sins of the past, present, and probably future would all get destroyed in the fire of sanctity that gets generated by singing the glory of the Lord and by doing service to Him with His eight flowers. So let us all sing the glory and absolutely not worry about our sins being hindrance to this virtuous path. Once Andal said this, all her friends were extremely happy and they were now confident that they could proceed with the vrata. These girls are now going to start the vrata from the next morning, and the second scene of ThiruppAvai is to begin from the sixth basuram.